Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about the Trendelenburg sign. What is Trendelenburg sign? This person was Friedrich Trendelenburg. He was a German surgeon who lived in the late 1800s and early 1900s. His name is Trendelenburg. Okay, not B-E-R-G, but B-U-R-G. In fact, there was an article that was published in Lancet that said the exact sentence that his name is Trendelenburg and not Trendelenburg in 2003. And his name is associated with a gait, a sign, a test, a position called a Trendelenburg position and a reverse Trendelenburg position, and also two operations. So this is one of the fancy eponyms that is asked in many examinations. Now, to understand Trendelenburg sign, you need to know what is the abductor mechanism of the hip. During abduction, this muscle called the gluteus medius and as well as the gluteus minimus muscle, these two are the main abductor muscles that causes abduction. Now, this is abduction, as you can see here. And during abduction, you can see that muscle. That muscle is called the gluteus medius. This muscle is the gluteus medius that is getting highlighted over here. When that gluteus medius muscle contracts, the abduction of the hip occurs. Okay, it is very clearly seen here. And the other muscles that are present around here are all faded in this position. And this muscle causes this abduction of the hip joint. But abductor mechanism is not only important for the abduction of the hip joint, it is also important when you stand on one foot. For example, you are standing on the right foot here, and then the abductor muscle, which arises from here and attaches over here, that muscle, when it contracts, okay, when that muscle contracts, it will cause the hip bone, the pelvic bone, to be stabilized. Okay, hip bone and the articulated pelvis to be stabilized. That means if this muscle is weak, then this will not remain like this. This part will sag downwards. Okay, so that will, this will be the new position of the articulated pelvis. So this doesn't occur because this muscle contracts. Okay, so the only the contraction of this muscle will cause the stabilization of the articulated pelvis. That is why this is so important. Okay, now we are going to see what is a Trendelenburg sign. So this is a normal configuration. A person is standing on the right foot, as you can see here. And at that time, this abductor mechanism muscle contracts and the pelvis is stabilized. Okay, you can see the pelvis is stabilized. So this is a normal configuration when the abductor mechanism is functioning normally. Now let us have a look at a weak, at a mild weakness of the abductor muscle. Okay, here there is a mild weakness. Now in a mild weakness, what happens is the trunk, in this case the trunk was standing erect, the spine. Now here you can see the trunk is slightly bending towards the weaker side. Now here there is a slight weakness of the abductor mechanism muscle, that is the gluteus medius and minimus. There is a tendency for the hip bone to sag downwards, the pelvic bone to sag downwards like this. But that is not happening because the body tilts towards this side and brings the center of gravity. The chance for the center of gravity is to move like this and fall like this. But when this happens, when the body tilts towards this side, then the center of gravity can be shifted back towards the center. So that's how the body compensates for a potential sagging down of the opposite side of the pelvis. So in this case, you will have a slight shift of the body towards the affected side. This occurs in mild abductor weakness, and this phenomenon is called Duchenne phenomenon. Duchenne phenomenon. Okay? Duchenne phenomenon. Now, suppose you have a severe abductor weakness, that even this type of a movement of the upper part of the body doesn't compensate for the tendency for sagging down, then the pelvis will sag downwards. Okay, so this was the horizontally lying pelvis. So from the horizontally lying pelvis, it has sagged downwards. This is what is called as the Trendelenburg sign. Trendelenburg sign. So in Trendelenburg sign, what happens is A person who has a very, very weak gluteus medius muscle, when that person stands on the right foot, okay, so this is the right side gluteus medius weakness, then the left side hip will sag down, and that is called as the Trendelenburg sign positivity. All right? Okay, thank you so much.